that's a shot that you've made a number of times over the course of this season, as early as it is. So when you shoot it, did you think that was going in? And what was your mindset when you let that go?
Yeah, I thought it was going in. It looked good when I left my hands. It was a little right, you know, so maybe I had to touch it up a little bit more. But I liked the shot. Maybe I could have shot the three. I mean, you know, after the screen, but I got to watch film. I'm sure we'll get that situation back again throughout the season, and I can capitalize on it again. But it was good to play in a fourth quarter game again and play a game that's that we had to, you know, fight uphill and claw back to get.
Nets Nation, what's good? It's your boy AJ back again. It's Nets News. Make sure you guys like, subscribe, hit that notification so you don't miss a video. So, tough loss yesterday, but we back again today against the Memphis Grizzlies. So, I'm going to do a quick breakdown. It's not going to be that long. The Memphis Grizzlies depth chart has, as you guys see here, is Ja Morant, Grayson Allen, Dillon Brooks. Now, Jaren Jackson Jr. is one of their stars and one of their young, great players, but he is out because of a meniscus. So, he's not going to be back for a while. So, they start Kyle Anderson at that 4 spot and then Jonas Valanciunas at that 5 spot. Now, quick notes about the Grizzlies starting five. Like, they all kind of can shoot. Like, Grayson Allen can shoot, Dillon Brooks can shoot threes, Kyle Anderson can shoot threes, and Jonas Valanciunas can shoot threes occasionally. So they can. I think the Grizzlies made this lineup like that because they know Ja Morant is so lethal at attacking. So he's gonna have a lot of lane, a lot of space because they can really go five out space. Now, as far as the keys here, there's only one key and one key only. I hope Steve Nash writes this on a chalkboard in giant letters. Ja Morant. Now, Ja Morant, what can you say? Like, I love this kid. This kid is, to me, Ja Morant is like Russell Westbrook 2.0. Like, he is that lethal. Like, he is just amazing. He's young, fast, athletic. He has court vision. Now here, when Ja sees he has a mismatch or edge on the defense with his superior athleticism, he isn't afraid to challenge big guys at the basket because, like, they're going to set a lot of screens for Ja. They're going to have a lot of horns action, a little double screen action with two big men, and a lot of pick and roll action. So Ja is going to attack the basket. He's more prone to attacking the basket, so we got to lock that up. He also likes to go backdoor a lot when he plays off the ball, so we have to watch that too. He's a backdoor machine. Like, people tend to overplay him because they don't want him to catch, but he's going to go backdoor. And now with the pick and roll, Ja loves to attack. So 9 times out of 10, he's going to attack whoever switches on him. So we got to watch out for that. Whoever Steve Nash puts on Ja, like, I hope it's Karis. Whoever Steve Nash puts on Ja, they got to watch out for that. When they switch, Ja is going to attack. And he's so athletic and fast, he usually just goes right by that switch and scores. Like, he is amazing like that. And in transition also, this is where Ja Morant stands out. Like, in transition, he catches alleys, he throws dimes, he's just so athletic. So make sure in transition we gotta stop the ball. We gotta know where Ja Morant is every time there's a fast break because he is just lethal like that. Now, as far as threes, right? He's a career 33.5% three-point shooter. He can hit when he's wide open, but he doesn't like to take a lot of threes. That's one part of his game he just still needs to adjust, but he's still young. Like, he's not gonna go for that three. He's not gonna take a lot of threes, but if he's open, he'll take one and he'll make it sometimes. But it's like, that's not his go-to. Like, he struggles with threes sometimes. So it's like, that's one part of his game he's gotta fix. But every other part of his game, as far as scoring off the basket, rebounding, assist, is amazing, off the charts. So that is the game plan. Stop Ja Morant. If we stop Ja Morant, I promise you the Memphis Grizzlies are going to have a hard time unless we play a terrible game again. But I don't think if we stop Ja Morant, I don't see Memphis beating us, y'all. I don't see Memphis beating us. But again, let me know in the comments what you guys think. Stop Ja Morant. All right. That's all we have to do. Stop Ja Morant. That's all we have to do, y'all. So let me know in the comments what you guys think. What do you guys think Steve Nash is going to start in this? Who do you think he's going to start this game? Do you think Kai 7-11 is going to rest? Or do you think one of them is going to play? I'm pretty sure Karis is going to start. But do you think 7-Eleven is going to play or one of them is going to rest? What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments. It's your boy AJ's Nets News. I'm out.